got to start the beginning of our trip right here at Hell's Bay. And mangrove forest is what we're heading into, so let's go. First little incident of the trip, Michael just flipped over somehow in the mangroves and lost some equipment, but luckily we're still in 3 foot deep water, so we were able to get it back.
The first day of our trip, we followed the Hell's Bay canoe trail that went through the mangroves from our launch at Point A to our campsite at Point B. The National Park Service had the trail very well marked with PVC markers to avoid getting lost, but the markers stopped once we made it to our campsite. That meant that on the second day, we had to be conscious as to where we were using our maps and GPS. We planned to head north towards Lane Bay, where we would turn west leaving the mangroves and follow the southern shoreline of Whitewater Bay until we made it to the South Joe River Chickee, which will be our second campsite.
Right here.
No. What is that? Yeah. First fish of the trip.
That's called ladyfish?
Yeah.
Can I take a...
It looks like a little tarpon. That's what I thought it was because it jumped out the water.
I already got several.
Okay. See you, dude. Thank you.
hell? No, that's a speckled trout. I'm down, dude. I'm talking to the fish. Speckled trout. Fish on. Oh, he came. That's another little trout. That one's even smaller than the last one.
Day 3 would be an easy day to navigate. All we had to do was head north from the Joe River and cut through Oyster Bay until we arrived at the Oyster Bay Chickie.
Puffy fish. Puffed up for me.
This would be our last day in the bayside of the Everglades. We would follow the Shark River out into the Gulf of Mexico, then head south to camp on Northwest Cape Sable.
I was just trying a little crankbait out through this channel and I got spooled. Something hit it, and before I even had the chance to turn its head, my line was already all out. It probably took close to 100 yards out on its initial run. It's probably a shark or something like that.
Giant tarpon. Woo! Woo! Woo hoo hoo! Woo!
Giant tarpon.
Woo! Woo! Woo hoo hoo! That was crazy.
There you go. I need to tighten that drag down. Woo! What is it? Oh, he came off. No, you don't. Off in the wood.
On day 5, we would keep heading south on Cape Sable until we got to Lake Ingram, where we would cut across the lake to make it to our next campsite on East Cape Sable.
Big shark, holy crap. Look at that shark. Woo! Yeah, what's up, dude?
The last day of our trip had taken us 11 miles from our camp at Cape Sable to the boat launch at Flamingo. But my truck was still parked 10 miles up the road at the Hell's Bay Pudding. I had counted on catching a ride from Flamingo to my truck, but that ended up not being the case, and I had to jog the whole way back to the truck. The last thing on your mind after finishing a through paddle is going straight into a 10-mile run, but it is what it is sometimes.
11-mile paddle, followed by a 10-mile jog, and I'm here.